Hello and welcome. I am Scrapperlock, and this is City of Villains on the Rebirth server. We are with our level 47 Mastermind Nightmare Lass, who has almost 30 million XP. We will be just under 30 million XP when we get to level 48, and we have closing in on 100 million infamy. However, we also have, where is it? 275 merits. So another week or so. Minimally, if we get the veteran rewards and possibly earlier from doing story arcs and stuff, once we have 300 reward merits and we're level 48, we should be able to put a set in Painbringer. It's also potentially possible to put a set in Anguishing Cry, World of Pain, and in Dark Embrace, maybe even Teleport Foe if we six slot that, which I may do. We're going to get two slots here. At some point, we may put another slot, not really sure. We only have the level 48 and 50 slots, so maybe not, because we do want to do tactics. And tactics will get a slot at 48 and 3 at 50, so we will not be able to 6-slot tactics. So you can't 6-slot everything. I don't really see any wasted slots here where I would want to respec. I think everything is kind of where I want it to be. So it's really a question of, do we want to fully upscale the buffing here with a full set? It also does a little bit of mez defense, or do we want to fully upscale Painbringer? And I think we want to fully upscale Painbringer, because that will increase globally the healing that I do from all of my healing powers. And that's, again, as I said in the last episode, what we're basically doing in battles, it mostly is being a heal bot. So anyway, we're on a story arc for Vernon Grun, and he says, "Well, it looks like the cursed gaze of responsibility for the destruction I have wrought has been turned upon us by no less than Arbiter Deus himself. A Night Widow delivered an invitation to a meeting with him. However, Deus wishes to speak with you first, no doubt to get a separate story from each of us. And I was so close. I had just learned that the Kray Industries had captured an organelle of the Hamadon, the creature that spawns the devouring Earth. That thing could tell me what I wish to know and allow me to undo my tragic mistakes. And now I must spend all my time preparing my case for Arbiter Deus. But wait, there may be time. That is, if you're still willing to help, Nightmare Lass." Okay, I'll still help. "First, you must speak to Deus. There is no avoiding that grim task. Then, while Deus interrogates me, you will enter the Kray compound here on Granville Island and find that organelle. But first, take these last creeper seeds. I've never even used them. Stop giving me creeper seeds. How many of them do I have now? Are they actually adding up? I don't even see them. Now, they're in there somewhere, I'm sure. But I'm just curious how many doses. We probably have about 12 doses of it now. All right, so now we need to go talk to Arbiter Deus. We're still on plus one times two missions. I greatly enjoyed doing the missions on times two players. I think that may be the sweet spot for us, even if we drop down to plus zero to fight an elite boss. I think we'll leave it at times two. I think going more than that is just going to make the missions take insanely long. But the times two, as Kiavar reminded me, because I'd forgotten about this, doesn't just up the number of guys in a spawn, it also increases the frequency of bosses. So we've been fighting several bosses per mission now, which is actually quite fun, right? It's really challenging. Well, not really challenging. It's more challenging. It's pretty challenging when they're plus two purples. If we ever got them into plus threes, it would be super hard. But when they're reds, it's just a good fight with a boss and a couple of minions. And it forces me to think about what I'm doing, which I don't have to do if they're plus one at times one. So, once again, thanks to Kiovar for that suggestion. That's an awesome suggestion, and I really don't know why it didn't occur to me to do it earlier, except that I think I just got caught in a trap of thinking about plus ones versus plus twos versus plus zeros, and didn't think about how many, you know, sort of the group size we could simulate, how many players it would be, right? So now we're on times two. And I think that'll be a lot more entertaining. He says, "We've been watching you help out Vernon von Grun, Nightmare Lass. In fact, we've had our eye on him for quite a while now. Von Grun is a genius, all right. He's also reckless, immoral, obsessed, and likely a danger to everyone around him. In other words, a perfect mad scientist candidate. We've been wondering when he'd finally make his big break, and it looks like what he needed was some professional help. A pro-level villain, I mean, like you. I'm not upset about the base. A base here or there is a small price to pay for good mad science. Why do you think we keep Dr. Eon around? That guy's a complete loon, but if you need to power a city by tapping into an entombed demon, you can't let sanity stop you. And organizations like ours always need more mad scientists. Sure, we've got Eon and Weaver J, and even Grillo, when he really gets into it. But compare that to the Council. Nosferatu, Vandal, Arkan, Burkholder, even Requiem dabbles in mad science sometimes. And don't even get me started on Nemesis. We need more mad scientists if we're going to keep up. And we've been hoping that Von Grun would make the leap. It looks like he will, thanks to your help. Now, I have to interrogate him to see how well he rants under pressure. How well he rants. He wants to make sure he gives good monologues. That is very, I like it. That's a good little sort of satire or whatever on comic books. In the meantime, you should check out that Hamadon organelle that the Kray have. So he knows everything Von Grun's doing, and he actually approves of it. And my guess is they want Von Grun to think he does. They don't approve of it, so that Von Grun will stay mad scientist-y enough. So we're going to go ahead and investigate the organelle in this lab. So this looks like the standard laboratory map. Is there anybody down here? There is, so we will summon our pets up here. So as I mentioned last time, I have picked a new game, but I'm not going to stream it or record it. Lara Croft's Tomb Raider. It's not Lara Croft. It's the Tomb Raider reboot from 2013 is the first one I started. It's a trilogy now. I guess next year, later this year, they're getting ready to put out a fourth, but it's sort of a trilogy of the origin of Lara Croft being a Tomb Raider. And so I'm playing the first one. And I have to say, it's a lot of fun. I don't know why I tended to turn up my nose at the Tomb Raider franchise. I think because I hadn't really... I think initially I didn't have the computer power to play it early on in the 90s when it first came out. And then once I did have the computer power to play it, I think the Angelina Jolie movie had already come out, and I kind of didn't like that and thought it was a bad movie. And that kind of gave me the impression that Tomb Raider is kind of dumb, because the movie was kind of dumb. And Larry's getting his butt kicked over there. All right. Ah, there's a lieutenant. I didn't realize that. I thought they were all minions. So, yeah, I guess I didn't think much of the movie, so I assumed I wasn't going to think much of the game. But it turns out at least the one that was released in 2013 or 14, Tomb Raider, I've enjoyed so far. I've played it maybe an hour and a half. I haven't played that much. I'm still in, like, the first chapter. But I'm enjoying it. And there's the lieutenant, so we want to hit the lieutenant first. So we can, because Curly will freeze him, and then he won't be able to do any damage to our guys. And that takes care of the power tank, and then the rest of them should be easy pickings. So you can see that the order in which you do the attacks is very important, right? In the last spawn, we started with minions because I didn't see the lieutenant. You're not actually going down the elevator, are you? No. I didn't see the lieutenant, so we did him kind of last by accident. And one of the consequences of that is that the lieutenant got to really pound on Larry and do a lot of damage to him. So you can avoid that if you make sure that you get the lieutenant first. All right, so we've done everything on this level. So let's go Go back. Sorry, guys, making you run around, but you can follow me. Yeah, so I've been greatly enjoying it. The graphics are quite exceptional for a 2014 game. I'm really impressed with the graphics. Okay, Lieutenant first. I need to be careful here not to aggro everybody else that's in the room, because that's a room full of different spawns. So come back toward me, that's good. Fight the guy near me. And then this guy. Right, and then there may be another loot. There's another lieutenant. Do we need to pull these guys? We might need to pull these guys out. So one of the things I like about having this on times two is that we do, you know, in the past I've done pulls when it's not been necessary, but here I feel like it's actually necessary because there are so many spawns in that room that there's lines of sight are going to overlap. Like say the guys on this side. And the guys on this side, and there's a very high chance you could end up aggroing two or three oversized spawns, which would cause a lot of difficulty. So it kind of forces you to use tactics again, which I really hadn't been doing when, even on against plus twos when there are only three guys. Because my minions just crush them so easily, right? Or one guy and a lieutenant. Oh, he's out of range, that guy. Oh, he's a lot further away than I thought. This guy is the one I thought I had. All right. Yeah, I targeted the wrong guy. There we go. I will say I'm pretty bad at Tomb Raider. There are certain aspects of it that are very Twitch gamey, you know, where you have to have really good reflexes, and I, as anyone watching these playthroughs can see, I don't have very good reflexes. It's one of the reasons I love this game, because you really don't, for the most part, need to be super good at reflexes. You know, in other words, you can just click on things, and it's not so reliant on split second timing. And there are not always, but in certain moments of the Tomb Raider game, there are in fact a lot of now we're going to aggro this other spawn. There are in fact a lot of sections of the game where you have to. Yeah, we over aggroed. I should have done more. I thought as I did this, maybe we should do some teleporting. And I over-aggroed. Yeah, we're gonna have to retreat from this and redo it. So I'll just go back and resummon. The other thing about that game, unlike this, is there's a lot less margin for error. So if you screw up, you can like die super fast. Right now, all I have is like a bow and arrow, no melee weapon at all. So if something like wolves were coming at me at one point, and like if I miss it with the arrow, then it's on me, and you have no like melee weapon that you can use to defend yourself from the wolf attack. So then you just have to like try to kick it, and it's very like if you don't jiggle the joystick exactly the right way and click the Y, press the Y button or whatever exactly at the right time, it just kills you. So it's very sort of twitchy, but they don't, it's not twitchy that often, and the rest of the game is quite interesting and fun. And I do like that you are able to change the difficulty. So one of the problems I was having early on is even though I set the game difficulty to normal, I had set the somehow it had automatically set the combat difficulty to hard, and I didn't realize it. So I was able to I was able to, when I realized that, change the combat difficulty to normal, and then it was a little bit better, a little bit less hair trigger. But as anyone who's watched this stream knows, I don't really like the hair trigger reflex games because I don't have good hair trigger reflexes. And any game that relies on them, there's sort of like a plateau I can hit. I remember I was playing awesome game, Top Spin 4, I think it was, one of the Top Spin games. And so it's tennis, and obviously that's very reflex based, right? Because you have to, hit the ball properly and stuff and time it really well. And I was able to get decently good at it so that my character could, I went from like losing every single set against the every single match against the AI love six love six to being able to play against the AI and get into tournaments and win the smaller tournaments and do okay until I came up against a named tennis player like Maria Sharapova or something, and then I would just get absolutely crushed. And I mean, not even close, right? I'd go from being, winning in straight sets against everybody else to playing a named tennis player and losing in just 6-1, 6-love, and just getting absolutely destroyed. Like, not even just losing 6-1, 6-love, but I can't even win a point on their serve. I can't even, they return my serve and just for automatic winner after winner after winner. And I just couldn't get to the ball. It just came so much faster. And so there's really this plateau. I could get just so good. And I was good enough to beat like the generic randomly named players, but like the top, say, 16 were named actual tennis players with actual stats of the tennis players at the time, and I couldn't beat any of them. And no matter what I did, and I tried many times, I played a lot of tournaments, and I would get to the semis or the finals of the, medium tournaments. I never did get to play like Wimbledon or anything because I couldn't get my rank up enough because I couldn't win the medium tournaments. I could only get to like the semis or the finals, and then I would get up to a named person and just I couldn't beat him. I just don't. There's sort of a limit to how high my reflexes can go. Wow, look at that. Okay. There's a limit to how good I can get at a reflex-based game, and I just can't go above that limit. And so it all depends on the game, but I recognize my limitations. And obviously, that tennis game, I could have just set it. You can set it easier, right? So I could have set it so that I could beat the named guys by making it like super easy. But that would have made every other match like ridiculously stupid. All right, guys, come back here, please. Come back. Come back. So we need to defeat the manager. He's probably in here somewhere. We're gonna have to clean that out little by little because there are so many guys in there. It's like four spawns. Teleport. Best power I've taken for this character. What a lifesaver. One of the best power pull powers in the game, along with single target taunts from scrappers. Like Warrior's Challenge is also a great pulling power. A great example of where a computer game differs from like a tabletop role-playing game. No game master would allow you to pull bad guys out of here like that. The whole room would see that people were disappearing and come to investigate, and you'd have to fight all the spawns at once. But the AI is stupid. So you can peel them out one at a time, and they don't notice that the room is getting less and less crowded. Ah, this guy noticed finally. Somebody noticed. Well, that was only two spawns. I thought there were a lot more guys in here. Do I hear a glowy? I thought I heard a glowy. Nope. Okay, well, that wasn't as bad as I thought it was. I thought there were more spawns behind. Which way did we come? I don't remember, so we'll just go up this way, and hopefully it's the right way. Yep, looks good. Oh, these are oranges. Is there a red lieutenant in there? Doesn't look like it. Okay, so we can just head in. Come on, click. There we go. So a times two plus two spawn. This is like as tough as it gets. We're doing fine. As tough as it gets, not including, of course, bosses, which we haven't seen any of. It's interesting that the Devouring Earth produced a lot of bosses, but these guys have not. Lieutenants, yes. Bosses, no. Is this a dead end? It is. Okay. Oh, okay, we're going to need to do some pulling here too, because there are usually a couple spawns in this room. Still no boss. Alright, let's start with the nearest guy. You gotta wonder what the demons think of this. Like, do they really want to just go straight in? And are they bored by me, like, pulling them out one at a time? Or do they enjoy, like, just gang-banging one guy and crushing him super fast? I don't know. I mean, obviously, they're computer programs, they can't enjoy anything, but just thinking in character, what would a demon like? Not sure. They might like the mayhem of just fighting two spawns at once. We should be right to move on in. Yeah, that game, Top Spin 4, I think it was a great game. I really enjoyed it. I'm kind of bummed that it only exists for the Xbox and I think PlayStation. They didn't make a PC version, which like very much bums me out, because if they had, I would probably try playing it again. I enjoyed that game. I realized that I would plateau at some point, but that's okay. It was still fun to play the lower level matches. And it was fun to, like, have my character slowly progress and get better. Because, like, you had... It was kind of like a role-playing game in the sense that you could unlock abilities, experience points, and then you could get, like, a faster serve and better speed around the court. And, you know, each character could be different. So I had, like, a male player who was, like, a power player and a female one that was more of a finesse. And actually, the female one, the reason I know about playing Sharapova and stuff... I was better at the finesse game than, believe it or not, even though I have crappy reflexes. And the reason is that you needed better reflexes as a player for the power game, because you had to like press and hold the power shot exactly the right way. And if you over or under did it, it would just net the ball or knock it out, which of course is very similar to what happens in real tennis. If you don't hit the ball, if you try to do a power ground stroke, and you don't hit it exactly right with the right amount of topspin, it's just going to go sailing over the fence, or it's going to hit the tape and fall down below the net, right? It's just not going to work. And I just healed the wrong guy. So, yeah, it's very accurate representation of what actually happens in tennis. But there's a reason why in real tennis I was never a power hitter either, right? In real life, when my friends and I played tennis in high school and college, I was a finesse player. I'm just better at that kind of game. Is Curly bugged? I am so sick of this bug where they get stuck. That is just really lousy. The developers should have made a command where you could just say get up or something and it would teleport itself to vertical and in the right position as long as it wasn't in combat or something. Because it's really annoying. To have to keep resummoning these guys because they get stuck. And it's always the big ones, it's never the small ones. The base manager is just a lieutenant? That's pretty lame. Go kill him. And unfortunately, there's no way to make them immune from knockback. The Mez defense, this thing here, enforce morale, will help you with their... Look at this, he's doing it again. The Mez defense will help you with other types of Mez, but not with knockdowns or knockbacks. So the Glowy is over there. Alright, we're going to have to fight these guys, and then I think we're about ready to finish up. Yeah, I would say one of the biggest challenges with the minions is that they're vulnerable to knockback, and after getting knocked back, they just stay down because of a bug. And wow, that is cool. So this must be the Hamadon organelle? And we have completed the mission, so I'm not going to worry about them chasing this guy around. We'll just head out. So we have a Hamadon chloroplast or something. Wow, it's 30 minutes just for that mission. Von Grun says, amazing mental contact with Hamadon Parsalima, the mad science genius who became the Hamadon and created the Devouring Earth. Did you get a sample? No, wait. Must stay focused. The important thing is that we cannot allow the heroes to gain by this. If this Zen flower succeeds in domesticating the Devouring Earth, it will be a disaster for all the evil in the world. If there is anything mad scientist cannot abide, it is the forces of good profiting from his plans. I will not allow it. Fortunately, my interrogation went well. It seems that while Arbiter Deus is concerned, he has no concrete evidence. Indeed, he suspects nothing of my genius! Or of my true plans to rule the world. Laugh with me. Moo ha 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 ha. I don't know if you've noticed, but I've been trying a couple of different styles of evil laugh. It's hard to pick the right one. This guy cracks me up. So I'm very close to putting an end to this heroic usurpation of my mad scientific genius, but a problem has occurred. Something has reawoken many of the Devouring Earth specimens I had you capture, and I got to fight them again. And now they're running riot in my own lab. They could destroy my work. I need you to subdue the beasts in my lab, or all will be lost. All right, I guess we'll do that. This will be a long episode, but we're so close to level 48. I think we should level up. You'll have to defeat all of the beasts, as well as recover 3 pieces of my work for safekeeping. As you know, I work for Operative Grillo on the Fury Project, so it isn't just my lab. There are other people there, and they are sort of my co-workers, so it might be good if you could get them out too. Oh, we're going to have to leave these guys out. All right, well, let's head over. I'm not going to bother with the teleport since it's right here. Doesn't seem to be the end of the story arc. We've still got a little bit of his progress bar to go, and my guess is this will be the end of his arc. But we're not going to have to, like, I'm not going to have to go off screen to get to level 48 because we're already almost there, and I think that's because of the times two. I believe we're also getting some bonus XP for the mission as well. So that was 24,000 for that mission. It's so hard to judge it because of all the different levels of XP bonus that have been going on. And we're still on patrol XP. Off we go. Oh wow. All right. Tons of DE. Let's go get the granite first. Freeze him. That's it. We just don't want those cairns coming out. Well, this is a fairly small level. And these guys, I think, are like way easier than the Cray. Oh, except he's beating up my little guys back here. So we gotta protect them. Good job, Curly. Right, now this room is usually pretty awful. Yeah, we're gonna have to pull them out. But I'm gonna do it in sight of them so they all come running out. Hopefully, get away from the cairn. And now we can get this guy, and we're not in the cairn, so we should do plenty of damage to him. Good job. That was perfect. Yeah, the Devouring Earth definitely are not as tough as the Cray. At least the rock ones. Against these guys. Now, that doesn't necessarily include every single enemy, archetype you could play, right? They might be, I think they would actually be quite a lot harder for, say, my stalker who does lethal damage and these rock guys are resistant to lethal, right? But there are two spawns here, one on the right and one in the center. So, we definitely want to pull. Mostly because I don't want to get two different guys putting out cairns. That would suck if there were lieutenants in those spawns, and it's really hard to tell from here. You can see our guys are making pretty short work of these spawns. But it definitely takes longer to do a mission at times two, right? There's no question about that. I think we can go in now, no problem. And there is one of the granites. So we're going to hit him first. And of course the cairn is up, so let's destroy it. Now we can go back to the granite. And then the boulders. It's interesting how at the lower levels, the devouring earth are mostly the plant ones, and then when you get into the higher levels, you fight a lot more of the rocky ones. I guess they believed, the developers, that the rocky ones, and maybe they are, were more difficult. And I think they probably are if you're not a mastermind, shooting with guys spouting fire, you know. So we have 3 scientists and 3 project elements. This could be a very long mission. Especially if we have to keep peeling guys out of the spawns. But like in this case, the minions are going to have a hard time getting up there. So I just as soon pull them out one at a time. And if a couple extra ones come, that's all to the good. But this does definitely lead to much longer missions. Right, because if they were just like 3 minions, there would be no reason to pull. Even in a setting like this. Right, even with the ramp up here and the minions having a hard time going up the ramp, you wouldn't need to pull them if there are only 3 guys up there. Because if half the minions get stuck, it wouldn't matter. What happened here? Did we aggro somebody? Looks like we aggroed maybe some of those guys. Alright, so there's an elevator up there. So this is going to be one of these 3 elevator levels, it looks like. Right, there's one. And there will be at least 1 or 2 more. This is solid down here. You guys done fooling around? Oh, there's rebels in here. Yeah, go kill them. This is just minions. We can go straight through. So it's morning. And, My actual, actually late morning, and I'm able to do this because it's raining out again today. But my actual plan today was to do work. I've got my zoology class doing a semester-long project using the website eBird, which, if you've never heard of it and you like to do birding, is a great resource. They're also associated with a site called Merlin Bird ID, so you can basically go birding, identify birds with Merlin, and then log the birds that you've identified, and keep track of it. And so I'm going to have my students, and we don't need to fight these guys because they're in a dead end. I'm going to have my students do that and, keep track of their data. And so I had to write the instructions on how to use the website and everything. And I've been putting this off, like literally since I thought of it in October or November of last year, because I knew I was going to have to take screenshots, highlight different things, step-by-step instructions for the students, and it's just a hassle. And I didn't want to deal with it. And so every time I started working on my zoology class, I worked on something else. Well, I got all the other projects written, and the syllabus is basically done. So, other than actually recording classes and setting up the learning management system shell, which I can't do yet because they don't have it ready, as we're not starting classes for almost a month. And I just heard today that it's ready, but at the time this morning, I didn't know that whether it was ready or not. I said, well, all I have left to do is this project, so I'll work on some of it today. And I figured I'll do a little bit a day and hopefully get it done by the end of the week because I got to start recording lectures next week. And I did the whole thing. Once I got started, I actually did the whole thing and it only took me a couple hours. And so now I'm rewarding myself with some City of Heroes. All right, let's see if we can get these orange guys out here. I don't know if I'm going to hit him. That room definitely has to be pulled because this is another one of these places where there are going to be a whole bunch of spawns all together. Now with this guy, as he was coming, I let him come past the column. Why? Because I don't want to repeat of having our, and we've leveled up, I don't want to repeat of having one of our guys get caught between the pipes the way they did in one of the last episodes. So now these guys are going to be yellow, so that'll make it easier, and some of them will be white. And we are level 48, guys, and we have almost a whole level of patrol XP still left, so we're still going to be getting some extra experience throughout level 48. And there are only two levels to go, level 48 and 49, before this character is basically done. Yes, thanks to the triple XP weekend or week, holiday season, whatever. I've gotten a lot more leveling done than I expected in a very short period of time. I at this point, without triple XP, we'd still be like probably a couple beads into level 47. Maybe even not quite 47 yet. All right, I'm gonna have to pull this guy out because I'm afraid my guys are gonna aggro the others in here. So he was dumb enough to put his cairn down back there, which means it won't help him. Go get him. We do have to get rid of this cairn, though, because it will buff the other DE if they come into its radius. Go. So now we need to pull from this spawn. This is definitely a slow process when there are this many of them. Right, and again, this is an example of that if we had just three guys per spawn, or one guy and a lieutenant, we could just go into that room with impunity. But because there are so many of them and they're so spread out, it makes it very dangerous to go in there because you could over aggro like we did the last time. And there is a glowy on the right-hand side. And a prisoner on the left-hand side. You can see him right there, it looks like. Or maybe not. Yeah, it looks like a prisoner. We'll see when we get over there. And again, the granite was stupid enough to lay the cairn down and then run at us, which is pretty dumb because they can't get the benefit of it now. So we'll teleport the cairn over here. Oh, and there are guys. Ah, Well, that's bad. So there are guys on the other side, too, that I didn't see. We gotta kill the cairns. Alright, so that cairn's done. Get the granite. Get the next granite. Gazzini cannot tank him by himself. Come on, guys, get over here. What is taking you so long? Kill the granite, come on. Oh, we put out another cairn. Kill it. And then granite. Yeah, the granites are a pain. Everybody else is not so bad, but the granites are a pain. I do think it's kind of boring. I mean, maybe they think the boulders are stronger than the other guys, and I think the granites kind of are. But I think it's kind of boring that you don't fight any of, like, the razor vines or the mushrooms or anything. After a while, they're just making you fight the same guy over and over and over again. I'd prefer if there was a little more variety. Alright, so we killed that off. Let's get the glowy. This is only one of the three that we need. And then there are just three boulders fighting. Why are they fighting with each other? I thought maybe there was a scientist over here, but it doesn't look like it. Wow, we're 1/6 of the way through this mission. But I don't think it'll be too much longer because there's only one other elevator, right? And this isn't that big of a level. I guess the last level could be gigantic. But they don't usually have huge, giant levels in these science labs. Sometimes they do. Okay, so there should be stuff up here. And there is a boss. A devoured. Alright, so pull back. Take out the white cons first. And then we'll get the boss. Oh, wow. There are two bosses. Wow. Okay. Alright, you guys are going to have to stay here. I'm going to turn invisible and see what we're dealing with. There's just that one white con. It almost looks like they're threatening an NPC, but I don't see... Oh man, and another boss over there. Wow. That is something else. Alright, let's pull the boulder over. First, thin the herd. You're kidding me, I missed a white con? That is ridiculous. All right, and now we're going to need all the help we can get. Notice I'm kind of ignoring the rebels and just letting my guys go at them. Alright, boys, come with me. In you go. We're going to fight three bosses at once now. So I'm going to come in the middle and try to debuff them both. This is going to be a heck of a fight. This is cool. I don't know if the guy from downstairs is going to see us or not. He might. But maybe he won't. That's one. These devourers are really cool looking. I mean, they're like gross, but they're cool. Like super monstrous. I like it. With these tentacles coming out of their faces and stuff. Very cool. I have the feeling all the scientists are going to be on the last level. I never did have the slots to buff up any of my attacks. Okay. This side. Okay, there are guys in there. This is a dead end. Alright, let's deal with the guys in here. Oh, wow. Alright, guys. Stand back here. We'll teleport people out. Or boulders out. Yeah, so the rebels, when they attack my guys just attack them back, so I've started not even really purposely targeting them. I mean, sometimes I do, but whatever. My guys will take them out. They're so weak. I guess we don't need that red. And we'll have a couple extra break frees in our tray. We don't need that either. Oh, I interrupted myself, didn't I? That was dumb. There we go. There's a scientist. I'm not leading them out, by the way. I'm going to just keep them with me or ignore them until the end of the mission, because it's not worth it. Now, we definitely have to make sure these guys get killed, because I think he won't stop cowering until all the spawns are dead. Okay. Alright, so he's freed. We don't have to lead him out. That's good. Oh, you know what? I think we do have to defeat all, don't we? There was that one group that I said we don't need to kill them because they're in a dead end. I think we are going to have to defeat them, aren't we? Because it's a defeat all. Oh, the cairn. Get rid of the cairn. Oh, and they were smart enough to freeze the granite. Good job, guys. You know, it's funny. In past games, particularly a couple of the games like Dragon Age, it was a one as an example of it, and I'm trying to think of a couple of others, but Dragon Age stands out in my mind, where even if you script, they allow you to, like, they have to let you script the NPCs because their AI script is so bad. And if you dare put it on the setting where you like click on the ground and then you let your character auto path somewhere, it'll go the wrong way. It'll get attack of opportunities on you when there's no need for that and stuff like this. And I used to call the artificial intelligence of games like that artificial stupidity, because it's not very intelligent. And if this is defeat all, it's going to suck. Let's see what's in here. I'm gonna try not to defeat all just because of how long this video already is. I don't know if there are any glowies in here. So I'm gonna take a look. Doesn't look like it. And I don't see any scientists either. So we're gonna leave this. I will pause it if I come in here because it's gonna take too long. So guys, you're gonna come with me. And we're gonna go to the next level, and we're gonna at least try to get rid of the sort of inventory of what we have to do first, and then I'll clean it all off up, clean it all out off screen. Because it's too long. We've already been going for nearly an hour, so we've got to finish this up. I don't want to make 2-hour YouTube videos. Okay, so we got to go this level. I don't think we've been through this level, have we? And it's pretty big. Let's see what we've got. So that's a dead end. Usually that's a dead end, yep. So let's see what's past this door. Somebody's talking. Might be a boss. All right, so this is going to be another pull. Oh, these are all white cons. Never mind. Come with me. Hit the granite. Oh, there's a devoured. I was dumb. I didn't see the boss. All right, we'll be all right. He's just a regular boss. Yeah, these knockbacks kill us mostly because the minions don't get up. Is Curly gonna get up? I mean, I don't mind that there is a certain clock on it where you have to stay down for a second because that's the damage mitigation. Okay, fine. But I don't like it when they get caught in this animation trap where they can't get up. And I'd love it if there was a way for me to put a buff on them that prevented them from getting KB'd. But I don't think there is one that we can give them other than break free. So there's a glowy and a scientist over there. So go get that, and I'll click. This may show us where the other glowy is. Nope, it did not. Scientist freed, so there's one and one left. Right, there doesn't seem to be any in here, so we're gonna keep going. And if I've got to clean out the lab, I will do it off screen. And then just bring you back for the end of the mission. Because it's just nuts. Yeah, I've never understood what the point is of all these empty sections of the lab. Like you could just made it, they could have just made a smaller map. Those areas never have spawns in them, even on, I guess maybe if you're on an 8-man mission, they do. But they generally never have spawns in them. All right, wait here, guys. I'm gonna take a look. Okay, so there's a scientist and a glowy in here, so this is the last room, unless we have to defeat all. So let's take off the invisibility. We can go without the stealth for a few minutes. Okay, they're coming at us now. Good. So that was a perfect pull because it got them out of the room. And then after this spawn, we can go on in. Kill the Cairn, please. Come on, attack. There we go. Yeah, every once in a while they do it where, like, I tell them to attack and they all just stand there and look at the guy. I don't know if they're all just recharging their powers or what. I mean, they're not low on endurance. Okay, go get the granite. Nope, still didn't beat him to the cairn. So we have to take that out first. And then granite. You know, there's a tab selects, I don't know, the next target in the list. Shift tab is nearest target. There's another one that does farthest target. I wish there was one. I don't think there is. I wish there was a way to say select most powerful target. Right? So it'll select the boss first, then the lieutenant, then the minion, or vice versa, select the weakest target. But I don't think there is a command for that. It'd be super great if there were. Alright, you guys are going to go free the scientist. I'm not worrying about the rubble. And I am going to click the glowy. Alright, so all we need is to free the scientist and possibly defeat all. I think probably defeat all. Yep. Alright guys, I'm going to pause it here. I'll defeat everybody and I will bring you back when we're on our very last spawn. Alright folks, I believe we are about done. Just finishing up the last few guys in this section. And I think this is the end of it. I hope this is the end of it. I think I've been everywhere else. And so there were more spawns on each of the other levels, but I took them out. There might be more up here, actually. I think I checked that, but I could be wrong. And I'm pretty sure we have to defeat all the rubbles. They count. You can't leave any of them. And there is a greater devoured. So we have a boss up there. So I brought you back so that you could watch us fight the Devoured. And that would be a cool climax if that's the last guy. Let's debuff him. So now the other bosses we've been fighting were plus zero to us, and I think were lesser devoureds or just devoureds. Maybe I'm wrong. But this is a greater devoured, so they're a little tougher, but not that much. And we've got him. And it looks like there's a one more guy that I missed back here. Right there. So, of course, it's a granite, so he can put down a cairn, right? Because he wants to be a pain. You've got to be the most pain in the neck you can be at the end here, right, guys? Why are they not damaging the cairn? Come on. They can't reach it. Alright, now they're getting it. It's taken a long time. And that is the mission. Alright. Let's head out. We defeated everybody. We saved his lab. And there's probably one more mission on this story arc, but we're certainly not going to do that today because it's already over an hour. And he says, "You have done well. My lab is saved. And now it is time to complete my work. My mad genius had been misused by the hated heroes of Paragon City and this Zenflower creature, and it is time to restore the unnatural balance and bring about her doom." I guess Zenflower. If you have an ally, you, my ally, shall be the one to carry it forth. So my guess is this is going to be an elite boss. We're going to have to drop this down to plus zero, but we're going to stay on times two. It does make the missions longer, so I may only be able to show one mission per episode, and we may have to do a little more cutting away. On the other hand, man, we are getting experience super fast, so you know, we're getting toward the end of this. We just have levels 48 and 49 to do, and then this character is finished. What a journey we've had. Been a lot of fun. New power. Next level. Okay, so we're going to finish Painbringer. And I guess we will put one slot into Tactics. And then I'm going to go to the super base and put on the reduced endurance and heals that I've already made. But I'll do that off screen. And I'll see you tomorrow, next time. I am Scrapper Locke, and this has been City of Villains.